I'm Kristyn Burtt for LifeScript.com. This summer marks the 20-year anniversary since Shannon Miller led the U.S. women's Olympic gymnastics team to its first ever team gold. With 7 Olympic and 9 World Championship medals, Shannon remains the most decorated male or female gymnast in U.S. history. In 2010, she battled ovarian cancer, and she's here to tell her story today. This summer also marks the 5 years since she's been told she is cancer-free. Shannon, thank you for joining us at LifeScript today.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me on.
So Shannon, tell us how you found out you had ovarian cancer.
I found out that I had ovarian cancer really when I found out I had a baseball-sized cyst on my left ovary. And that really happened first at a regular kind of routine appointment with my physician. I had felt fine. I didn't realize that I had been having any symptoms of ovarian cancer. But a month later, I had surgery to have the baseball-sized tumor removed and found out that it was a rare form of ovarian cancer. And I was very lucky. I followed up with a pretty aggressive chemotherapy regimen. And today marks 5 years cancer-free. So I'm very fortunate.
Now, while you didn't have any symptoms, are there any signs that women can look for?
There are definitely signs and symptoms that women can look for, and I think it's called the silent killer, but it's really not all that silent. I think sometimes we're just very focused on so many other things going on in life, and because the symptoms are kind of those everyday symptoms that a lot of women go through anyways, we don't always think of them as signs for cancer. And in those things were bloating, frequent urination, stomach aches, sudden weight loss, even back pain can be a symptom. So if you're having those things and it persists for more than a couple of weeks, then you do want to get to your doctor and just begin that conversation.
And can you tell us about the OVA1 blood test and what it means for women?
Absolutely. So the OVA1 blood test was not available when I was diagnosed, but shortly thereafter. And this is a great tool for physicians and for women to be able to utilize. If they have a pelvic mass, which 1 in 5 women will have a pelvic mass, and most of those will not be cancerous, but if you have a pelvic mass, you can then take this blood test. And that will help determine what your risk is for cancer, for that mass being cancerous. And then you can get to the right specialist. It is shown that survival rates increase by 40% if you are with the right specialist to perform that very first surgery. It is absolutely critical. A lot of women, and I was one of them, didn't know that I needed a specific type of surgeon to perform the surgery, certainly before I knew whether or not it was cancerous. So this is a great opportunity. It's a great tool for women to be able to use and for physicians to be able to use.
Shannon, did your health and exercise regimen change after your cancer diagnosis?
My health and exercise regimen definitely changed, I think, to some degree. During cancer, during chemotherapy, if I could get up out of bed, get dressed, walk twice around the dining room table, well, I was just as thrilled as standing up there on that gold medal podium. That was a win for me. Certainly I do more now, but a lot of it's walking, it's swimming, it's yoga, it's those things that keep me active, try to keep that flexibility, do a little weight bearing, but just keep me moving throughout the day.
So can you share your mental and emotional journey with ovarian cancer?
I think the mental and the emotional portion of going through a cancer journey is so critical to face, and really not just for the person going through it, but really for the whole family who is all kind of in this together. For me, of course, my faith was first and foremost, and so that is really the guiding light, what helped me through the tough times. But I think also just having those positive people around me. I just kind of shut out the negativity and tried to focus on the positive, really lean on my team, which is something I certainly learned through gymnastics. Setting goals for myself, I learned that through gymnastics. And I think keeping that sense of humor alive, even when I lost my hair, my husband was able to kind of walk that fine line of making sure that we had that humor in it while we had the understanding that it was a tough time.
So what is life like now that you are 5 years into remission and a mother of two.
Life is very busy, just like every other woman out there. I work really hard, but I enjoy my children so much. And I think that's probably one of the blessings that I have kept throughout my cancer journey. And that's just stopping and smelling the roses and really understanding that I need to appreciate and be so grateful for every single day and just making the most of it.
Now, where can women go for more information?
So women can definitely go to knowpelvicmass.com, and that is K-N-O-W, pelvicmass.com. And that's a great resource for learning more about pelvic mass, OVA1, and really those signs and symptoms for ovarian cancer.
Shannon, thank you for sharing your story with us at LifeScript today.
Thank you.